Hi, and welcome to the Rugged Rundown this week. Today I'm going to be talking about the 2024 Rugged Laptop Buyer's Guide and what is it that you should consider when taking a look at these units. And I think the number one thing you need to consider is whether you need a fully rugged or a semi-rugged laptop. And that's going to depend on your environment that you're working in. So if you're in a hot, dirty, grimy area that is got vibration and everything else, you're going to want a fully rugged. If, for example, you're just in your car and you're mounting it and you're running around doing work, maybe you're a contractor or whatever, you could go with the semi-rugged. Semi-rugged might be like the FZ55 or Getac S410. Then what you need to look at is the specifications of the software that you're going to be running. And that's going to mean, what is the processor in these units? What kind of memory do you need? How much? And the other thing is hard drive size. How much hard drive space do you need? I always say the more hard drive space you can get, max it out as much as you can. You'll never, ever not have enough hard drive space then. The other thing you need to look at is the ports. So ports are important. You know, what kind of ports are you going to need if you need to hook up external devices? Like, do you need USB 3.0, HDMI, FireWire, remember the old FireWire? Do you still need the 9-pin serial port? I mean, if you still need the 9-pin serial port, you might want to consider the CF33. But those are important questions that you need to ask whenever purchasing a ruggedized laptop. Another thing is the screen. Believe it or not, the screen is very important. Do you need touch? Most ruggedized laptops are touch screen, especially if they're fully rugged. The other thing you need to talk about is, what kind of touch is it? Is it the standard touch that you can just use your finger and you can touch the screen and get where you need to go? Or are you going to be wearing gloves? Well, you need glove touch, which the FZ40, you can use a glove. Let's say you're using the laptop in the rain. Well, whenever it's raining, that can affect touch. But with the FZ40, you can use the touchscreen in the rain. So that's very important. The other thing is, am I going to be using the laptop in bright daylight? So there's something called nits, which measures the brightness of the screen when you're in the daylight. The higher the nit rate, the better you can see it in the daylight. So if something like the FZ40 has a nit rating of 1200 nits. The CF33 has 1000 nits. The FZ55, 800 nits. So the higher the number, the better you can see it in the daylight. But they all are considered daylight readable. So those are questions you need to ask. Another important factor that you need to consider is battery life. So how long do you need to use the laptop without being plugged into the wall? And that will determine what kind of battery configuration you need in the laptop that you're buying. So for example, in the FZ40, you get the advantage of having one standard battery, but you can add a secondary battery to gain battery life. Same thing with the CF33. 33 has two batteries, both here. You can buy the unit with extended batteries. They can give you up to 20 hours of battery life. Do you need it? I don't know. You may not need to go to that expense. Same thing with the FZ55. Nice thing about the FZ55, there are two ports. A battery can go on one side and another battery on this side, so you get double the battery life. So another question you need to make sure you ask yourself is, how much battery life do I really need? Or is it just going to always be plugged in? Let's say you're mounting your car, it's always going to be plugged in. You don't have to worry about the battery. All you would need to worry about at that point is specifications of the laptop. Well, that's all I got for you this week. Don't forget to leave your comments down below. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, please, and I'll see you next week.